Hi, welcome to this video tutorial on grouping on more than one column. In this session, we will learn the need to perform grouping on more than one column. We will also learn how we can perform this operation with group by clause of select statement. We will also discuss some commonly performed error by users during the usage of group by clause so that we can avoid it. And in the end, we will demonstrate the implementation of grouping on more than one column. Let's start this session.
Sometimes there is a need to perform grouping on more than one column. It means that first grouping is performed on first column and then within that group, grouping is performed on second column. Let's understand this concept with an example where we wish to find total salary paid to each job title in each department. In this case, first grouping will be made on department field. And then within the group of each department, grouping is performed on job field so that total salary can be found for this subgroup, that is each job within each department. In simple words, here we wish to perform a group within another group. To understand this concept, let us consider the given database of employee having 5 columns: employee number, e-name, job, salary and department number. And we wish to find total salary paid to each job in each department. To perform this operation, only 3 columns, that is job, salary and department number, will play its role. So let's simplify this database by selecting only these 3 columns. To perform this query, first grouping will be performed on department number. First group will be created for department number 10, second for department number 20, and third group for department number 30 employees. Within each group, grouping is performed on job. Since there is only one job title in department number 10, so subgroup of only one record will be created for job assistant professor, for associate professor and for professor. In department number 20, we have 2 records for assistant professors. So these 2 records will make a one subgroup for department number 20. There is only one record of associate professor in department number 20, so it will make another subgroup. In department number 30, subgroup of assistant professor will have only one record. Same for associate professor, but a professor subgroup will have 2 records. So here we have a group within another group. First we perform the grouping on department number, and then within each department number we perform subgroups on job title. After creating these subgroups, a sum salary function will be applied to each subgroup to display its corresponding total salary as shown here. The query to perform above task is select department number, comma job, sum salary from employee, group by department number, comma job. Here in group by clause, we have specified 2 columns, department number and job. It means that first grouping is performed on department number and then within each department number, grouping is performed on job field. Let us consider next task to display total salary for each job in each department, excluding the records of associate professor. In this case, first step will be to exclude the records of associate professors as shown in this database. And for this, we have to use where clause of select statement. After exclusion of these records, grouping will be performed on department number field, and then within each department number, grouping is performed on job field as performed in previous case. Here, for simplicity, we are only considering 3 fields: department number, job and salary. So first grouping will be created for department number 10, then for department number 20 and for department number 30. Here we have 2 records in department number 10, 2 in 20 and 3 in department number 30. Within each department number, subgrouping will be created on job. We have only one job of assistant professor in department number 10. So this subgroup will contain only one record. Subgroup of professor in department number 10 will also contain one record. While subgroup of assistant professor in department number 20 will contain two records as shown here. Subgroup of assistant professor in department number 30 will contain only one record, while subgroup of professor in department number 30 will have two records. After having each subgroup, sum salary function will be applied on subgroups as shown here. And the query to perform this task will be select department number, comma job, comma sum of salary from employee where job is not equal to associate professor, group by department number, comma job. Here where clause has been added to remove undesirable records before group by. And in this case, grouping is performed on two columns, first on department number and then within each department number, grouping is performed on job field. There are some errors which normally a user make in the usage of group by clause. And one should be very clear about this logic so that we should not make such mistakes in the usage of group by clause. In a select statement which contain group by clause, only those columns are allowed in retrieval list of column on which grouping has been performed. No other column is allowed in select column list except group by column. For example, if we are making a grouping on department number field, then we can only retrieve department number column in select column list with some aggregate function as shown here. For example, if we try to select ename with department number column and aggregate function, then it is not allowed because data is already grouped on department number and all the columns of department number are reduced to a single record. And with this single record of department number, we cannot display the group of E names because it will be non-relational as shown here. So it is not allowed. Is this query is allowed in SQL or not? Yes, it is correct since we are selecting only those columns in the select list which are used in group by. Here grouping is performed on department number and job and we are only selecting those columns which are used in group by clause. So it is allowed. But if we try to select employee number and job by having a grouping on department number and job, it will be not allowed because employee number is a column on which grouping is not performed. Let's answer this question, is this query is allowed or not? This query is not allowed as we are selecting an aggregate function and a column without using a group by clause. Let us move to SQL interface to demonstrate these concepts. Let us again consider employee database with 5 columns, employee number, name, job, salary and department number having 10 records. Here it has 3 records of department number 10, 3 of department number 20 and 4 records in department number 30. In each department number, there are different job titles, assistant professor, associate professor and professor. And in this case, we are interested in making the grouping on more than one column. Let us demonstrate this concept. Let's find total number of employees working in each job within each department. And for this, we have to make grouping on department number and job columns. It means first grouping will be performed on department number and within that department number, grouping is performed on job title. If I execute this query, it shows 3 columns, department number, job and count in the output. To make this output more informative, let's arrange the record in ascending order of department number. It shows that in department number 10, we have 1 employee working in each job title. In department number 20, we have 1 associate professor and 2 assistant professor. While in department number 30, we have 1 associate, 1 assistant and 2 professors. And this shows the importance of making grouping within the grouping. Here, first grouping is performed on department number and within that field, grouping is performed on job title. we can exclude some job titles in this output by using where clause. Here we are excluding the record of associate professors in this output. It shows all the job title except associate professor. There are some common errors which are made by users in the usage of group by clause. Let's understand those errors so that we can avoid that in future. Here we are making a grouping on department number and we are selecting department number and count of employees in these department numbers. Here we have three departments and this is the count. In this query, we are selecting only department number and aggregate function count. If I try to select any other column in this select statement, it will be not allowed because only those columns are allowed in select statement which are involved in group by expression. Here we are making a grouping on department number, so only department number and aggregate column is allowed. No other column like ename, enumber is allowed in this query, and if you try to write it, system will display an error message. In order to display department number and job information and total employees in each job, we have to make grouping on job column also. Here we are making grouping on department number and job and then we are selecting department number, job and aggregate function. This query is allowed because we are selecting two columns and both these columns are involved in group by expression. But if I remove job from this, then system will raise an error. So it is important to note that in select statement, only those columns are allowed with aggregate functions which are involved in group by expression. It is important to note that if we want to use aggregate function, then it should involve group by expression in the query. If we remove this group by expression, system will raise an error that it is not a group function. So either I have to select only department number, it will execute. But if I want to display count with this department number, then it is important to make a grouping on this column. Otherwise, system will raise an error. This is all about the demonstration of these concepts.
Now let us summarize the concept we have learned in this session. In this session, we have learned the need of making the grouping on more than one column. We have also discussed its syntax and its usage. We have demonstrated the use of different examples in SQL to explain this concept. We have also discussed the commonly performed errors by users during the usage of group by clause. In next session, we will discuss the role of having clause of select statement with group by clause. Thanks for watching this video.